Hello everyone. This video is an introductory overview of PharmCAT, the pharmacogenomics clinical annotation tool. If you're watching this video, you probably already know that pharmacogenomics is a research subject that investigates the influence of genetic variations on drug responses. In the rest of the video, we will refer to pharmacogenomics using its acronym PGX. In genetic study, a person's or a group of people's genetic information can be stored in a file format named VCF. PharmCAT is a software tool that interprets PGX variants from a VCF file and generates a personalized report. This report includes genotypes, phenotypes, and phenotype-based drug prescribing recommendations. Now, PharmCAT is a one-stop tool that is composed of flexible modules, including the VCF preprocessor, the named allele matcher, the phenotyper, and the reporter module. The VCF preprocessor is important for standardizing and normalizing the variant representation formats in a VCF file for robust annotation results. Given the standardized and normalized input VCF, the named allele matcher matches the input PGX variants with the integrated allele definitions from guidelines in PharmCAT. The output of the named allele matcher is a metadata JSON file of matching PGX variants, alleles, and diplotypes. The phenotype module uses the metadata to translate the diplotypes into the corresponding phenotypes. The phenotype module also accepts external PGX calls from other PGX calling tools. These external phenotypes need to be organized in a specific format in a tab-separated text file. We will talk more about the outside call in another video. Similar to the named allele matcher, the phenotype module outputs a metadata JSON file. The final reporter module uses this JSON file to connect the phenotypes with the prescribing information from curated guidelines and combine them with additional messages and caveat warnings to generate a personalized report. The final reports include an HTML and a JSON file. Currently, the VCF preprocessor is a standalone module written in Python that users should run prior to the other PharmCAT modules. The rest of the PharmCAT modules are all included in the PharmCAT jar file and run sequentially by default. In other words, you can run the whole PharmCAT using one Java command. We also provide a pipeline script to run the whole PharmCAT, including the VCF preprocessor module. Again, we will expand more on this in another video. If you double-click the HTML file, this is what you will see as an output on a web page. So you have four sections: the genotype summary, the prescribing recommendations, the allele matching details, and the disclaimers. The genotype summary section shows an overview of the gene-drug pairs and what their genotypes are. If you click on any drug, it will directly take you to the drug prescribing recommendation section, where it shows you all of the genotype-based drug prescribing recommendations from different sources with links and citations. In addition, there is a section that lists the PGX variants per gene. In this section, missing variants and other warnings that are relevant to the genotype calling are included. This is an example of the ABCG2 gene, but you can also find many more about other genes in this section. So this would have been the third section that you see at the top of this HTML file. Specifically, the last section, the disclaimer section, lists all of the exceptions, cautions, and warnings in interpreting results. This is perhaps the most important but often most overlooked section of the whole report. You can always find the latest PharmCAT release following the button on the PharmCAT homepage. It's open source and under active development. PharmCAT stays current with the content sources such as PharmVar, CPIC, and PharmGKB curated prescribing recommendations like the DPWG guidelines. If you want to stay tuned to any PharmCAT update, please consider subscribing PharmCAT following the link on the PharmCAT homepage or on the show notes below.